According to the hospital director, Dr. Patrick Odongo, the hospital currently refers patients who need special attention to other referrals because they don't have enough specialists.
We still need to train more health workers so that they get more skills and competences.
Dr. Odongo says the hospital has 120 staff out of the 534 required to run the facility.
For increase, we are going to target one, the specialists, which I have already mentioned, in the areas of surgery, obstetrics and gynecology, and medicine, internal medicine.
He believes that with the 10.2 billion already allocated for the facility, they will be able to recruit more staff to fill in some of the gaps. Dr. Patrick added that the low staffing has increased workload for the available staff, hence affecting the effectiveness of work at the hospital.
Prioritize midwives. They are very critical because of the activities they do in maternity, deliver, labor suit. Some of them go to the theater, then management of mother, postnatal, and the infant. And then we have the neonatal intensive care unit, which also requires them. Then we have nurses. A lot of work in our hospitals are done by nursing.
Hussein Hudu, the RDC Yumbe district, has appealed to government to speed up processes to the funding of this hospital.
Yumbe Regional Referral Hospital is a sign that government is playing its work. What is challenging is that our people don't know that they have such a facility.
Residents have decried the poor services at the hospital, urging leaders to fast-track the development process. We are really struggling here. In most cases, one staff is moving to work in different areas and it's really overworking the staff. We thank government for bringing us quality machines at the facility, but we also need staff to operate them. Yumbe Regional Referral Hospital, which was upgraded on July 1, 2021, has a catchment population of 1.9 million people, of which over 400,000 are refugees. It serves districts of Yumbe, Koboko, Obongi, Moyo, Adjumani, and neighboring South Sudan. Story by Adam Gule for the news.